This is Ian in New Jersey. I'm here for
Who You Crappin'.
I don't even know where this crap comes from.
Hey, buddy.
And I'm getting tired of talking about this. Johnny Knox texted me this morning wondering where this crap comes from.
Hey, buddy.
If you guys keep making this stuff up and bringing this stuff up, you're going to deal with me.
Buddy.
That's what I said. That's what I said. I said I will read it. Don't you tell me what I need to say and what I don't need to say.
Who are you crapping?
Love the way you lie.
Who are you crapping?
Telling the lies, you're putting me down, you're starting to make me cry.
You guys had a call, and he said, you know, I'm a farmer. Who are you crapping? And then it gets on my hair. Man, where are we going with this?
Oh, crap.
One of the things, Mike, that's been pointed out over the course of today and last night after the game is that you seemed resigned to the fate after the game, that there wasn't much fire in you, and you sort of stood up before the media and said, well, you know, this is the way it is. Are you resigned to this fate?
You're the same guy that wrote about me when I did have the fire, that was the wrong thing to do. So who are you crapping?
Well, I'm just
don't
asking.
Crap
which,
me.
Which
no.
Who Are You Crappin' brought to you by Sport Clips Haircuts with 70 Chicagoland locations to serve you. Sport Clips, it's good to be a guy. As always, I want you to limit this to something someone said, not something someone did. And if you go too long, you keep on talking because you like to hear yourself talk. Bad things are going to happen.
And you know the rationale behind how to construct a political crap as well. They are allowed, if properly constructed, for any part of the aisle or any party you wish. Steve in Downers Grove will start us off on the score.
Hey guys, this is my first crap.
Good luck with your first crap.
This crap goes out to Channel 1 News. For the uninitiated, Channel 1 is a news company which broadcasts the news to teens across the country, reaching an estimated 5 million teenagers daily. On the October 15th broadcast, there was a segment on the risk of concussions in high school sports. Channel 1 wheeled out Dr. Mark DeFazio, a child neurologist at the Children's Medical Center. He and other doctors emphasized there is no clear evidence that just one concussion causes long-term damage, and there is no scientific evidence supporting the current recommendations for concussions, such as extended periods of rest. On the next day's broadcast, there was a segment on how coaches and athletes are using biometric technology to measure the severity of hits to the head. Wait, I thought if hits to the head don't cause long-term brain damage, and if there's no long-term brain damage, why do we need biometric technology to measure them? And Channel 1, who you crapping?
Who you crapping? Also brought to you by the Improv Comedy Club in Schaumburg. For tickets, visit improv.com.
Sean says, ahead of last Saturday's Florida State-Notre Dame game, Ray Glyer of Bleacher Report wrote a column titled, "This is the one weekend we should all be Notre Dame fans." Glyer began by discussing the reasons many people have disliked Notre Dame over the years before getting to his point that Florida State has now become more unlikable than Notre Dame. The crux of Glyer's argument was FSU's handling of the Winston case. And with that, I agree and have no issue. I couldn't believe that Glyer was actually arguing that people should root for Notre Dame due to the fact that Florida State has mishandled the Winston case. The irony seemed obvious to me. I kept waiting for Glyer to bring up the elephant in the room, and I thought he was going to do so when he wrote, Notre Dame has had its own scandal. I thought, finally, he's at least going to acknowledge the Lizzie Seberg situation. Yeah. He can't possibly ignore the way Notre Dame mishandled that situation where campus police waited 15 days from the time of Seberg's sexual assault allegation before they even interviewed Prince Shembo, the accused player. In other words, the same school that held a press conference shortly after the Manti Te'o catfish story broke to announce they would fully investigate what happened waited until after an alleged assault victim committed suicide to talk to the alleged perpetrator, Prince Shembo. But ignore the Seberg situation is exactly what Glyer did. The scandal he referred to was the academic dishonesty suspensions of five football players. So, Ray, I did not cheer for Notre Dame last weekend simply because Florida State's been abominable in handling the rape allegation against Winston. That would have required me to actively ignore the way Notre Dame mishandled Lizzie Seberg's sexual assault allegation. I refrained from cheering for either team. Ray Glyer, who you crapping?
Nicely done.
John is in Northwest Indiana. He's on the score.
This crap goes out to Tom Brady, who on his weekly interview at the halftime of the Monday night game on the radio was talking about the Bears coming up and said that it's going to be a tough test because they have a fantastic defense. Jay Cutler's kids have a better defense against polio than the Bears do against the mid-range passing game with Tom Brady. Tom Brady, who you crapping?
Like the side swipes as always. Larry Earp, CPA, says in a fan chat of the Bears website, Phil Emery asked what plans the Bears have for the Soldier Field turf. Here's Phil's answer. Number one, the Chicago Bears in the last 10 years have about a 625 winning percentage at home. We're below 500 on the road. We're in the top 10 of the NFL in home wins over the last 10 years. And if I had my druthers, I'd bring the Soldier Field surface with us on the road based on that record. It doesn't mean we don't constantly research what's best for our players and wouldn't make an adjustment in the future. Number one, Phil, don't say number one if there's no number two. Second, I'm surprised you didn't trot out the same tired excuse of waiting for more safety studies on field turf versus grass. My penultimate point is in the last 10 years that Soldier Field had artificial turf, 1978 through 1987, the Bears had a home win percentage of 70%. Clearly, the Bears were better off with artificial turf. So finally, you've already taken the Soldier Field turf with you to road games, and it's clear from your responses you've been watching Bears games while wearing Cap Boso's Turf Monster helmet from the 91 Jets game. Phil Emery, who you crapping? We're good.
Well, there's a lot of stuff in that little Phil Emery.
I don't. I know. And you can edit it. It's on the website. Mount Prospect. Bobby, you are on Who You Crappin' on the score.
Hey, guys. How you doing? First-time crapper.
Good luck with your first crap.
This crap goes out to Eddie Vedder, who earlier this week suggested trading Aaron Rodgers for Jay Cutler, like he was coming up with something smart. What he doesn't know is I called the Murph and Fred show 3 weeks ago and suggested that myself. So, Eddie Vedder, who you crapping?
This guy sucks.
Lose the number, dumbass. Jacob and Kerry says this goes out to Jay Cutler, who says he missed his radio show because he had to take his kid to the doctor. It's a worthy excuse. I face this problem at work. Who takes off work? Do I or does my wife? Jay's wife has no discernible occupation to which she's responsible, and they've both already expressed their disdain for responsibility anyways by putting their child and yours and mine all in danger by refusing medical wisdom and listening to the crackpot anti-vaxxers. But lo, when it comes time to be accountable, suddenly, medical advice can't wait. It's just too important to move an appointment by an hour. Jay Cutler, who you crapping?
Thought the same thing.
Mm-hmm. Joe in Plainfield is on Who You Crappin', as he often is on the score.
Hey, guys. This crap goes out to the grower of men in Chicago, Mark Trestman. During his press conference that was full of crap-worthy items, the smartest man in Chicago football decided to educate the masses by stating that he thinks, quote, it's a good idea for Brandon Marshall to be the talker and leader of the locker room. So wait a second, Mark. The answer you're going to give about what happened in the locker room Sunday is that it's a good idea for the same guy who went on a babbling tirade a few weeks back and embarrassed the organization you both work for that he should be the locker room leader? Mark, here's an idea. How about you lead the locker room and not act like you're a blithering idiot both on the sidelines and behind the scenes? As Brandon would say, it is unacceptable, unacceptable, unacceptable. Mark Trestman, who you crapping?
And that starts with me.
That's what we're doing. Who you crapping? Good so far. We always, and you know, here's the thing. There's plenty of time for you to jump on in, 312-644-6767. It is, after all, our signature segment, and we would like to have you in it. We really would, except if you're bad like that guy a couple calls before. If you're him, no, we don't want you.
We got lines open.
Yep, 312-644-6767. Who you crapping? Plenty of time to jump on in. Boers and Bernstein, Chicago Sports Radio 670.
That's where in the middle of it, as always, run Boers and Bernstein, Chicago Sports Radio 670 The Score. Very simple. You know it, and you love it. You know this last segment. We are looking for the big finish.
Alex downtown, you're on Who You Crappin' on The Score.
Hello, boys.
Hello.
All right. This crap goes out to Seattle-based group, the Freedom Socialist. The Freedom Socialist group is campaigning for a $15 minimum wage in Seattle, a very honorable effort. The campaign for $15 minimum wage could expose big businesses' phony concerns for small business by demanding solutions that correct the huge tax imbalance between corporations and genuinely small businesses, the group wrote. On the 15th of October, they posted a job for a web content manager for $13 an hour. I know everything is hip in Seattle, but practice what you preach, idiots. To the Freedom Socialist Party, I have two questions. Can you pick up a dictionary and look up the word hypocrite? And who are you crapping?
There's the essence of it right there. Perfect. That's very good. This is from one of my favorite monikers, Statutory Ape. This goes out to awful human being and Senate candidate Jim Oberweis. During the Illinois senatorial debates held this Wednesday, Jim Oberweis was asked, "Do you support a ban on assault weapons?" Instead of answering the question with a simple yes or no, as he was asked, he offered this personal anecdote. He told a story of his sister, who was accosted by a group of teenagers that broke into her home. According to Oberweis, she ran into a room where they found her, dragged her into the living room, and shot her dead. He then used that story to rationalize why he supports Second Amendment rights, stating that things might have turned out differently if she had a gun herself. That makes sense. If you're insane, which if you're Jim Oberweis isn't entirely out of the question. Jim, either your sister chose to not own a gun herself, or she happened to live in some bizarro world in which any and all guns were banned in the state of Illinois, thus preventing her from legally owning one to be used for her own self-defense. And according to everything I can find, that bizarro world doesn't exist. But apparently, the one where you dodge questions and use the death of a family member for your own cheap political capital does.
Wow.
Jim Oberweis, I know you don't speak question, but I have one for you. Who you crapping?
I did not hear that.
I'm kind of glad I didn't.
I didn't want to. No, right. Don't get me wrong, but that's I did not know that.
Here is expectant grandpa. Goes out to Monica Lewinsky. It'll be short and to the point, or to put it in terms she might understand, it's a quickie. This week, Monica addressed the Forbes 30 Under 30 Summit. She said she was the first person to have her reputation destroyed by the internet. She then compared her experience to that of Jennifer Lawrence. Sorry, Monica, you got it wrong. In Ms. Lawrence's case, private photos were stolen and published on the internet. We feel sorry for her that her privacy was criminally violated, but we don't think any less of her. Her reputation as a talented actress is safe. In your case, it was reported that while working under the president, you were, well, working under the president. That you were the butt of thousands of jokes was not because of the internet. Although, admittedly, it did make the transmission of those jokes much more efficient. No, the damage to your reputation was because what you did was really stupid. Blaming your ruined reputation on the internet is like blaming Lee Harvey Oswald's ruined reputation on television. Monica, I always thought you were a blowhard, but for a different reason. Monica Lewinsky, who you crapping?
Right on the edge there. He's right on the edge.
Yeah, that's really artfully done, though. Mm-hmm. That's good. Mm-hmm. Southside John, you're on Who You Crapping on the Score.
Thanks, guys. This is my first crap.
Oh, a lot of that. I love hearing that.
With your first crap.
My crap goes out to Kim Guilfoyle of Fox's pseudo-news show, The Five. On one of this week's shows, Kim was talking about how young people in America should not go vote, because they are, quote, uninformed. Well, ignoring the fact that our attendance for voting in this country is already astronomically low, I was under the impression, Kim, that it was the media's job to inform people. So maybe before you get on young people for being informed, you should look in the mirror, do your job, and ask who you're crapping.
Thank you, John. Dave says after breaking her foot, pop star dope Jessie J wowed us with this. It's put everything in perspective. I have a different respect now for people who don't have legs. Jesse.
Oscar's happy.
You do have legs. But wearing a cast on your foot and using crutches for a while might be a bit of a struggle. I don't think it's quite the same as actually removing your legs. They're still attached. They'll be used again. Why don't you sit down with a group at a local veteran's home to swap war stories and see how that goes? Jesse J., who you crapping? And along those same lines, I missed this, but this is unsigned. Sunday morning during ABC's Eyewitness News, after an inspiring piece by Hosea Sanders called The Disability Report, he spoke of people in wheelchairs playing tennis and the inspiration those athletes provide. After he gave some information on an upcoming wheelchair tennis tournament and how one could be involved, he sent it over to Tanya Babich. Tanya Babich gave us the segue of the year by saying, "If that doesn't get you out of your chair and moving, I don't know what will."
I have to start watching that.
Tanya, who you crapping?
Tanya?
Check the manometer.
You know, it's been good today. The manometer is ready to burst. I'm not giving any hints because I went fishing.
You went Manitoba.
Manitoba.
Ryan and Richton Park will bear the pressure of closing out who you crapping on the score.
How you doing, guys? This is my first crap.
Good luck with your first crap.
This crap goes out to the NFL and by extension, the NFL Network. Several weeks ago, Falcons return man Devin Hester broke the all-time return record. And as he did so, he chose to pay tribute to the man who held it before him, Deion Sanders, high step into the end zone using Deion's signature touchdown stand. Devin Hester was flagged on this play, and the Falcons were subsequently penalized 15 yards on the ensuing kickoff. Lo and behold, the very next week, who do I see on NFL Network promotional commercial videos? Devin Hester, high-stepping into the end zone on the very same play that he was flagged for. The last time I checked, unsportsmanlike conduct wasn't a highlight. NFL, who are you crapping?
You make us wonder what
that's not
say.
Something somebody said.
Maybe yeah, you not, but still, it's interesting.
Yeah, it is.
I've heard worse endings.
Hey, buddy.
Who are you crapping?
We've had worse endings, you know that.
I know. Oh, yes, we have. Update.
Yes, we have. Exactly.
Run into a wall endings, yes.
That wasn't bad. That was a good one. That's interesting for sure.
Right.
That's fine.
Yeah.